Hello everyone, today the topic for our video will be EPF simulation, in which we will able to learn how to file return and generate challan. For this, firstly we have to visit our student job guarantee page. Here you have to log in using your credentials. Then you have to click on the tab projects. You can see lots of simulation in front of you, but you have to select EPF. Now you can see EPF simulation homepage in front of you. It will give you the opportunity to work in the live environment. So let's start using your sign in. This username and password will be the same as you provide in your student job guarantee page. After putting in all the credentials, you have to click on sign in button. Now you can see the EPF dashboard in front of you, where your employer profile has been provided. You can check it from here. So let's start the payment method. We will go to the payments. You have to click on ECR return filing. You can see lots of quick links in front of you. You have to click on ECR upload. After that, some important notes are provided here. You have to go through the notes, then start making the payment. For this, firstly, you have to select the wage month. Wage month will be the month for which the payment is being made. So I am making the payment for the month of August. So I am selecting August as the wage month. Salary disbursal date will be the current date, so I am providing the current date in salary disbursal date. Again, you have to choose file to get uploaded. Before selecting any file, I want to share some details with you. The details of the file which needs to be uploaded here, it has to be maintained in an Excel format. So let me show you that Excel file which I have prepared. This file needs to be prepared in this format, using all the details of the members or the employees with their gross wages, EPF wages, contribution, everything. After maintaining the file into Excel format, you have to convert this file into CSV format. So you have to select at CSV, delimited, then you have to save this file. I am not saving it as I have one with me. Let me show you how it will look. After saving the file or converting the file into CSV, your Excel format will look like this. Then you have to open this CSV file with Notepad. It will look like this. You have to remove the column names. After that, you have to replace all the commas with hash, wave, hash, and your file will be like this. You have to save this text file, and this file will be uploaded at our EPF simulation. I'm not saving it as I have one with me. So this file will be uploaded at our simulation site. So let me upload. So from here, you have to click on choose file, then you have to open your file over here. Then you have to select the file type at ECR. You have to choose some contribution rate, and if you want, you can provide some remarks. We need to provide the remarks. Then you have to click on upload. After clicking on upload, you can see one message coming up here. You can see that your file has been uploaded. You have to come down to the page, and you can see that the file which you have uploaded is coming under draft ECR. This is the file which I have uploaded. You can download this file to check if all the details filled are right or wrong. If it's correct, then you can click on the verify button. Before clicking it, you can check the wage month from here, that the wage month for which you are filing the return. If it's correct, then you have to click on OK. After clicking OK, the file which was falling under draft ECR will come under in process ECR. You can see that the file which you have uploaded is now coming under in process ECR. You can check it, and you have to click on prepare challan. After clicking on prepare challan, One form will open in front of you. It will be a self-filled form. All the data and all the fields will be automatically filled up from the Excel sheet which you have uploaded. Only two details on some things are need to be filled up here. As you can see, the administration charges. If you have any, you can give the administration charges. If you don't have any, you can still you have to put zero, and you have to add the inspection charges. Then you can see the amount is changed. After that, you have to fill the total number of employees in a month. You have to write the excluded employees for which this return is not being filed. You have to write the gross wages of the employees, and then after filling up the details, you have to click on generate challan. You can cross tally the amount with the amount in the total. It's 82,119. The same amount is coming here, so it means it's correct. You can click and you can proceed. So click on OK. Now you can see that after clicking OK on that file, it automatically comes under draft challan list. Here you can check the amount, and then you have to click on finalize. One pop-up will come and you have to click on OK. After clicking on OK, you can see that the draft challan list, the form will come under in process challan list, and you can check the amount. You can see the status is due for payment. So now it means that you have to make the payment for your return. So you have to click on pay, and you will be redirected to your bank's page. Here you have to give your login ID and password. Again, it will be same as you have provided at your student job guarantee page. Then you have to log in, and you can see that the payment has been made. So the transaction is successful. So now to see or to print the challan, you have to go to the home page. So click on home, and then click on payments, payment ECR, and from here you can see the amount which you have paid is coming under it. This recent challan list, this is the amount which you have paid, and you can print or see your challan from here. So your process of return filing is completed. You have generated the challan. So thank you for your participation.